Okay. And we are now recording. What is your record keeper? It's the Yuffie event. And hopefully this one goes a bit smoother. From what I've seen of the fights, they're not that bad. But we'll see. So first off, the boss rush is just against a bunch of random things, and the Arc Dragon of, like, the first one, you fight multiple. This isn't even a boss. Red Dragon, I think, was a boss, and Schizo, coming back again, is actually a boss. And, it is a headache. Anyways, whatever. He's a headache. I hate him. He's the worst. Okay, so the brief breakdown. Yuffie's gonna be buffing herself with Steel Power and using Shadow Steel. Because it's a good move. And it does a lot of damage. Just a moment. Red is going to be doing debuffs. Rydia's got Black Magic and an AoE. Same thing with Rinoa. And Aerith has a heal. And Shelga, because Shell's gonna matter in this boss rush. Your restoration spell's on the bottom, and Katana's up 20%, and damage up 20% on red. Just, you know, your standard boss rush layout, build, whatever. It was quite hectic getting here at the time I planned. If you're not aware right now, the northeast of the United States is getting hit by a very bad winter storm. And started up right when I was driving home, which is fun. There we go. Alright. Let's see how this goes. Way to date your video. Yeah, let me just... There we go. Now it's properly dated. Huh. They're not even animated. You're not even trying here. So I'm gonna debuff the one up top and then take care of the other one as fast as possible. And then leave behind the one that is debuffed. That's the general idea right now. See how that works out for us. I have, and a number of people I've talked to have really come to love Steel Power since the Rubicante fights, where that was a big deal. It's just really kind of come into its own. It's just kind of really useful. Like, I did a lot of the dungeon updates after that event, And I was using steel power in every one of them. Oh, or we could just let him die to his own tick. Ah, no, that's not gonna be enough. There we go. Well, it was not bad. I was mildly worried about that one. And, you know, I do recommend honing steel power to 6. It makes it last for those long bosses. We actually made the Yuffie event quests, which were like doing whole stages with just Yuffie. Kind of easy. As it was good for buffing her. Just everything all rolled in one. Alright, so Red Dragon's kind of the same deal. He's got a couple really good attacks. Like his breath and all that. But actually I think all he has is breath and other crap. I think that's it. I think he's a one-trick pony. But with all the important stuff up, he's not gonna do any damage to us. Now I might actually be making a mistake here. But I think I should be fine if I don't save, what's it, for Schizo. Two Sentinel Grimoires for Schizo. I'm getting lucky with these saps. Like, quite lucky. Just gonna turn that up just a little bit more. In hindsight, maybe save those magics. Sap is going to be very important for this entire set of bonus fights. It comes up a lot. Not too much, just a normal attack does. Oh, come on. Oh, wait, just let him die to the sap. We got it. There we go. You gotta save those ability uses. Actually, I'm just gonna... Yeah, we'll put down the one for now. Schizo is a, you know, quick target the boss, so... I'm gonna try and keep that time up for myself. Just to make sure I don't get owned. Now, you'll see. Schizo, you need to debuff his head, but the problem is... He's really strong, and he attacks twice. Furthermore, each time a head dies, it does a big Dragon Fang attack, and it loses all debuffs right before the head does that attack. So, you actually need to, you know, buff yourself, or else. Can't just go off debuffs on this boss. Kind of the opposite of Barthantos. Where we ended up beating him with just debuffs. I think I can jack this up to 2. Now, the one thing that I'm doing right now that I do not recommend, and I will attempt to fix it in a moment, is I need to desync the heads. Do not want both the heads to go down at the same time. There we go. We'll see how much that Dragon Fang does. And it's not that much, we'll just kill the other head outright. Oh, that's not bad at all. Alright. I was a little worried, but that's not bad. Alright. That's a boss rush down. And I think somebody... in the line chat just reported beating the ultimate already, so yeah, doesn't seem like this one's gonna be too hard. Phantasm is a pretty good ninja ability. It's finally our 50% sleep ability, but it's ninjas only. So, that's the caveat. So, the Materia Keeper is the boss of this junk. And it should be noted that you have to slow and sap him. Yeah, Phantasm is also non-elemental damage, so there's that. You can use it on any boss. A thing to note about Materia Keeper is he has very high mind, which is the stat that determines status effects and all that. So, you can paralyze and stop him, but it only lasts for like half a turn. It's not a good strategy to base yourself on. So, I built a strategy based around not doing that. Not relying on paralyze and stop, that is. I'm going hell into status effects. Because he is actually vulnerable to a lot of status effects. So, Cloud going in with Break, Magic Break, and Tempo Flurry, Yuffie, Steel Power, Shadow Steel, Rydia, a Aja Spell and Blindga, Rinoa, Aja Spell and Meteor, and Aerith with Kiraja and Shelga. Increase cure, increase damage, increase damage, increase damage, increase damage from bottom to top. Nothing really special with these materia. I do want to find a Sentinel Grimoire though. Personally, you could actually also probably go into this with, you know, a Lunatic High. But, I don't want to take that many risks. We'll see how this goes with the Sentinel Grimoire. If it's overly easy, then you know. But you could probably Sentinel, you could probably Lunatic High it. Let's be honest here. The The conditions for the boss are, of course, slow and sap, so that's why those two abilities are being brought. I think I mentioned that already, but I wasn't sure. Man, with this new way I found of doing pictures, I get that done real fast now. Alright, so the first round is going to be getting all of our mitigation up as fast as possible. Yeah, and I have personally heavily invested in Shadow Steel. Your mileage may vary. And now I'm not getting the saps that I desperately want. Nor the slow. So that is the sort of game breaker in this fight, is if your status effects don't hit. That can be very bad. One reason that will cause you to have to reset. There's the blind. So now we don't have to worry about his physical attacks at all. That's why I really didn't bring any physical resistance to the fight. Oh boy, I feel as though we might be in this for the long haul. Just because she doesn't really have anything to do. No slow. Uh-oh. But you can see how strong blind is. It is just kind of completely debilitated him. In fact, I probably don't even need the steel power anymore. Alright, there's the slow. So now we just need to get the shadow steel to actually hit with the sap. And then we're good to go. I am a little worried about his trine, so we'll do a little bit there, just to make sure we don't get destroyed. Yes, Sentinel Grimoire does appear to be a bit overkill. A haste would probably be better. That's mainly due to the number of status effects that you can inflict on him. I swear, if all these Shadow Steels do not result... There we go, okay, now I can kill him. You know, Shadow Steel, while being a good move, is still only a 25% chance. It is just our only source of non-roaming warrior sap. So, it's what we have to resort to, unfortunately. But there you go. Also, not a terribly hard boss. Bring a Haska. Just bring Boone. Just bring Boone. You'll be fine with Boone. Boone and Blinga. He's done. a lot of wind orbs. With orb conversion brought in, you know, these major orbs are making it look a lot better. Oh yeah, that's right. There is a there's an FF6 weapon that can proc sap, but that is an even lower percent chance. So yeah, good luck there. Unlock my good dog. Look at that record materia. I want it so bad. That's so good. Alright. Boss number 3 is the 4 members of the pagoda all at once. This is also going to be a very easy fight because they all have about 70,000 health. They're all also vulnerable to an ass ton of status effects, including paralyze and blind, which we will take advantage of. The only caveat is the ball and chain man here. You need to slow him. I will be taking a 100% chance to slow in order to do this. That way I can one-shot it. So, as always, remove all. Now, I have mentioned before that we had gotten orb conversion. I have a lot of orbs. So, I'm just gonna click here. There's your summons. There's your Quetzalcoatl, which has a very good chance to hit paralyze. Up here on Yuffie, we have Steel Time and Flurry of Petals. She's probably not gonna run out of abilities. That's how long I think this fight is gonna last. Rinoa with Meteor, and Aerith with Protectia. Again, all damage ups on everybody, except for Aerith, who has healing up. I'm taking a Sentinel Grimoire. Once again, this is probably not needed. Just throwing that out there. Now, I did watch a video. Before you get mitigation up, they do hit pretty hard. They're all single target, but they can hit for about 2,000 damage. So, that's my reasoning for mitigation. But let's get to it. Oh, for once, stamina has actually synced up pretty well. Now, if Quetzal gets good procs, this fight is already over. So let's see what happens. Only one, wow. I probably could have done something better with that, but I actually honestly wanted to see that move, too. Alright, come on, Quetzal, round two. That's what I'm talking about. That could be a good move if buffed. You know? This guy in the back is actually going to survive thanks to his regen. Oh wow, geez. Yeah, so the other thing that you can do is you can actually bring a really jacked up Blade Beam Roaming Warrior and just completely decimate everything. And now we just wait for these summons to go off, pretty much. But yeah, I did not imagine this was going to be a difficult fight. In the least. Which is like, here's four targets. They have very low HP. Welp. Oh yeah, that's right. You can also bring Shadow Flare and blind everyone. Or that Samurai ability that does blind. There's a lot of options, actually. But, playtime's over. We had fun. But now we have to, fight Daddy. Down here. Sins of the Father, Ultimate. The boss is Godot. So, in the Ultimate, he doesn't have his gold mask form anymore. Or he doesn't have his white mask. No, he doesn't have the gold. Okay. Instead, he gets his cure as a counter when he gets low on health. He uses Trine and Beast Sword, which are all AoEs. Bioga, which is an AoE. Gravity, which is not AoE. And then Gravija, which is AoE. Yeah, he's kind of a pain. Might be a little rough. The only real condition here is inflict him with sap. You have to bring Yuffie, and you have to not get KO'd. Yuffie is going to be our sap machine for this. Oh, which actually reminds me. Let me just finish this off real quick. No reason not to. It's not that many eggs. I'll just dip into my wealth of growth eggs. Yep, there we go. I never miss leg day. Yes, I have a lot of eggs. Also, it's thanks to all the orb, the mithril refreshes I do during orb fests. Which, kids, never not mithril refresh during orb fest. Always do that at least a couple times. It's very useful. Anywho, so the basic breakdown: Yuffie, steel power, shadow steel. Cloud, Armor Break, Drain Blade, Red with Magic Breakdown and a Full Break. Probably do the Magic Breakdown first. Hope coming in as our Spellcaster with a Just Spell and Shelga. And Ishtola coming in as the healer with Kiraja and Protectka. You may notice the start with a break. That is because Ishtola is using her Medica 2 in this. That is my gimme. My give me weapon is on Hope. It is the Full Metal Staff. Pretty much damage across the board. The only thing I'm risking, being a little risky with, is I am bringing Sap Materia on Red. I wouldn't normally do this, but I have a good feeling about this. The hardest thing, I think, is going to be landing the Sap. That is the thing that is going to cause the most resets here. This party is pretty survivable. I actually have a lot of good armor for this realm through fucking luck. Not like I actually aimed for any of it. Alright, there we go. Well, I mean, the earlier I land the sap, the better, too. But let's not dawdle, that way I don't waste stamina. Alright. Also, standard rules apply. At the 2-hour mark on my timer, if I somehow have still not beat this guy, I am going in full force. Because, by the way, I'm holding back a lot. That was the wrong person to do that on, but whatever. Alright, so it's just all about keeping up with his damage. It's the major threat here. Yeah, as you can see, his gravity is kind of the biggest threat because it's the only thing I can't really mitigate. Luckily, Cloud's got that covered. Oh wow, that did a lot less damage than I thought it was going to. I preemptively Kiraja'd and that did like no damage. Yeah, the gravity is kind of the worst thing that he does. It is kind of brutal. It's a 50% gravity, so. Hopefully. We will be A-okay. But right now, seems alright. I'm not horribly worried. Which feels weird. I don't like it. Ah, okay, so he's in his weak state now. He will now counter Cura off any damage possible. It's only possible. So we do have to start being aware of that. He has a very weak state. Is why that's weak. Oh, does he speed up? Ugh. That's no bueno. Yeah, Sentinel Grimoire. Nah, I still think I'll be fine. Like, it's not throwing the towel just yet. Hey, there's our buddy Sap, finally showed up. Yeah, that's the threatening one. That's the one you have to look out for. I mean, you said yourself he's huge. So yeah. Also, yeah, he's obviously in the very weak form now. He just used fucking Gravagia. Also, I think my Sentinel Grimoire wore off again. That's luck. Come on, Ishtola. Get there. Get there, Ishtola. Nice. I was maybe hoping for a bit more health, but I'll take it. Uh-oh. Come on, Hope. Nice. Oh. Alright, so really all it comes down to is that Saf needs to hit earlier than the sixth hit. That's really all it is. Like, that sap kind of makes a difference. You think I should Sentinel Grimoire later? Yeah, still a good first attempt, right? So, banking on sapping never hitting. Perfect. Now she dies. Hey, just because I observed your advice doesn't mean. There we go! Hey! First turn, right? Yeah, but anyway, just because I observed your advice doesn't mean I'm gonna take it. Oh yeah, that's the other thing that somehow never happened last attempt. The Bioga, you can poison. As you know, Bioga is what to do. Ooh, Shadow Steel owns! It's like a good ability. Also, the thing I'm noticing, and this is handy, is he does so much AoE that anybody that you're planning to use a limit break on seems to always have their limit break up. Yeah, that is a good question. How did I never get poison last time, but four people got it this time? Yeah, who knows? Numbers. Shrugs audibly, you know? That might be a bit early for the Sentinel Grimoire, but we'll see if that bites me in the ass. Actually, I did enough damage that turn to knock him down, so actually fine. I might medic a 2 next turn. Just to get rid of the poison. So, frankly, if you bring a good Medica type roaming warrior to this, You're pretty much set. Or if you have a good one. Watch, here comes the poison. Nice! 10 out of 10. So that, Gravagia is going to be coming any second now. He does get fast in this final form, though. Yeah, there it is. Just doing it again. I just need to last another turn and have him stop fucking counter curing. Come on, buddy. Alright, I'm ready for the Bio Gut to come out again and just poison everybody. Huh, not this time. Ah, this is it. Come on, Sap, finish him off. Sap, finish him off. Get him with the sap. Don't get owned by B-Sword. Nice. Alright. Yeah, a way more manageable ultimate. Still pretty hard, but a Medica is kind of what you need for him. You know, I will take that after Barthantilus last week. Barthantilus, kind of a headache. Now, this mask right here, you know, that's not a bad idea. You could do a whole mage team and use put reflect on. I don't know. Yeah, if you use can you reflect a counter cure? That's an interesting concept. I don't know. But anyway, let's take a quick look at that. Sort by level, that way all the accessories are on top. Whoops, level descending or ascending. Because that is our first ultimate attack accessory. Other than the Omega Badge. The Omega Badge is an ultimate attack accessory. There it is. Yeah. Attack and defense. A very good accessory. Where's the Omega Badge? Here it is. Which is attack and resistance. So, yeah. You can cover for your defense weaknesses with those two. And then you got this one right here, which is like, yeah, you're good. You're situational, though. What was the other one? Oh, it was the medallion. That's what we got last week. Here it is. Ugh. That's a good defensive accessory. And that's pretty much it. I would never use that anywhere else. Anywho. That's it for Final Fantasy record keeper this week. Under an hour, my god. That's really short. Next week is Final Fantasy 9. Which is going to be a bit harder because I don't have much gear for that. So I'll see you then.